there's so much that goes into safeguarding your data in Office 365. We have layers and layers of security to make sure that your data stays secure. So we start with physical security in our data centers. We have network security to isolate our machines on the network. We have access control to protect our engineers and to protect your data. And then we have a red team that does great penetration testing, constantly looking for new vulnerabilities in the service. And then I have a blue team, that's my team. What we do is intrusion detection. So we are taking data off of all hundreds of thousands of machines in our data center, pushing that data up to the cloud, and looking at that data at those log events for anomalous behavior. Process starts, network activity, everything that happens in our data center comes under my team's microscope. The trick, though, is looking for that needle in a haystack in those terabytes of data every day, looking for the activity that really might indicate an anomaly, something that's unusual or out of the ordinary in our data center. And that's the real challenge. So it starts in the cloud. I have all of these servers globally in Office 365, and they're all uploading security events like process starts, application events, Microsoft Engineer activity like logons, network activity, all to a big data system in the cloud that we call Cosmos. And Cosmos is great. It holds petabytes of data. It scales in the way that we need to the scale of Office 365. Then I can take all of that data and try to classify it. So I work with my service engineers and my architects to define what known good activity looks like in Office 365. And I can take that data and classify it often. Then I can also work with my pen test team to determine what known bad activity looks like, what a real-world adversary would do. So I can classify that data, and if I ever see that, I can jump into intrusion detection or incident response. But then there's some data left over that doesn't quite fit either bucket. And there I use machine learning to build a statistical model of what my accounts, what my servers do. And then I investigate the long tail, things that are anomalous, things that haven't happened before and don't seem to be happening anywhere else. That's the place that I really want to spend my time. So for example, let's imagine that myself, as a Microsoft engineer, I need to get a list of processes that are running on a SQL server in our data center. I'm going to use remote PowerShell for that. And my intrusion detection system is going to pick up that I launched PowerShell, which is known good because our engineers do that all the time. It's going to pick up that I ran tasklist.exe on that Windows box on that SQL machine, and that's known good. It's a Windows binary. It's going to notice, you know, I don't typically connect to that SQL server, but enough of this is known good that we're going to let it pass for today. But let's imagine for a moment that I used psexec instead of PowerShell. Now, my intrusion detection system is going to look at the other engineers around me and say, no one else really runs that executable, right? That process is unique to you, and even you haven't run it in the past. So I'm going to get an audit email from the system asking me to confirm my behavior. It might be that I was running psexec to unblock myself, right, to legitimately get something done in the service, but the other scenario is that someone else is using my account without my permission. And so that audit email helps me distinguish and tell the security team whether that behavior was okay or not, so we can make our models better. But imagine for a minute, let's take it like another step farther. Let's use psexec again, but let's pass the flag that says run a system. Instead of running that legitimate Windows binary to get a list of processes that are running, let's instead run a process that I made that's going to transfer a lot of data off of that machine. Now my intrusion detection system is going to light up and send an alert because it sees a lot of network activity on that SQL server. That's unusual. That shouldn't be happening. And I'm running something, a system. That's known bad. It knows how psexec works. So all of these things add up, and my detection system is able to say, there's something highly anomalous going on. I have multiple factors that tell me that something's up. My security team needs to go jump in. So they're going to get that alert and go start doing forensics to understand really what's happening in the data center right now. We've made a huge investment in people and processes and in technology for security. We hope that when you put all those things together, the sum of it gives you peace of mind, makes you more confident that Office 365 is a safe place for your data.